Bro, you know what I saw, Magnus, yesterday? An old poster. When you came to Mexico, and it was like Drew McIntyre was on it, Brodus was on it. That's the one where you got hurt, right?
I tore my bicep. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was thinking about that. I was like, we never talked about that on the last show, but that was that was brutal. That's like the only, knock on wood, the only major injury I've ever really had in my career.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
But and how long were you out for that? With that?
Maybe 2.5 months. So I was supposed to be out for like 5, and I think I definitely came back too early. But I wasn't under contract at that point. I was working independent. So
you have insurance or what happened?
I had insurance. Yeah, no, yeah. It was no big deal. Like the insurance actually like covered all of it. It was actually one of the most financially one of the most pain free things I ever had. Like I've had. It's always the little like things that I seem to get f***ed on by my insurance. It's like they'll charge me through the ass for like physical therapy and shit like that. But like these major surgeries, like they took care of it. So it was all good. But
I also noticed that Mickey James was on there. Was she your girlfriend that by that time or that before? Okay.
We were together. I think that was.
So I might have bought you as a package deal or something.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah. I think we had Donovan by then too. I think that was some of her first shows back after having D. So yeah.
So how's your
how did you two start dating?
We started dating 10 years ago. We got
from
married.
What company?
TNA.
You were TNA?
Bro, remember she was a TNA when you Ravens flock back
in the day? That, yeah. But I'm saying but it's 2010. She started 2003. In TNA,
She was in the old Asylum days, and then she had a run in WWE, and then I started in TNA in January of 2009, right. And then she came in about a year later. Or I think
who hit on who? Did you hit on her? Did she hit on you?
She hit on me.
Did she?
Tell the story. So she had come in, and like the. One of the first things that she had done on TV was she was like singing, and then like Lisa Marie was going to attack her, and she was wearing this like little low cut dress, and you know she looked smoking hot, and like I remember she came past like in catering, and like I was sitting there with Doug Williams, and Doug was like, "Oh, put your tongue back in your mouth or something," right? Like it was obvious, right? But and I you know I just like I didn't you know I didn't make a move on her or anything, but then. I think that the next day of tapings, I had to go do pictures, like new 8x10s, you know, promotional pictures, whatever. And if you guys remember at the Impact Zone, like Lee South would set up the pictures stuff, right. The photo booth at the far end of the building, like down
in the corner over there.
Corner. So it just had to be like waist up. So I just put on my trunks, but I didn't put on any like my boots or pads or anything. I just put on like my trunks and like so like of course like I'm just you know I'm like 23 at the time, so I'm just like full of shit. So I just like put that on and just strapped through the whole building, you know. And she was in the ring with Lisa and Al Snow was their agent, and they were like going over their match or segment or whatever they were doing. And I just walked past to go take pictures or whatever. And I get like maybe 20 yards past the ring with it. And I just, and you know, she just never has any concept of how loud she is. And she just, I hear her just like turn to Lisa and go, "I'm a looking and I'm a lacking." and everyone heard, and I just turned and stopped and looked and like, and she was just like, "Oh," shit. And I never forget Al's face. Cause Al just looked at me like Al hated me. Al was like, and Al's just looking like, "Oh."
That would be a great vignette. They show we reenact that scene, and the second she says, "You know, I'm a looking, I'm a liking," the James Bond music starts, and you do a slow turn to look over your shoulders.
Give them the James Bond music, D.I.
That's a good story.
Just imagine if I'd have been wearing the suit, it would have been game over.
Think about this as like the year 2020. You liked you had the hots for your next door neighbor. You just knocked on the door, showed up in wrestling trunks. Hey, what's up? You know, I just want to come introduce myself. You know, I was like,
or think of this. Imagine if I'd have been one of those woke wrestlers and turned and been like, "I'm offended. How dare you objectify me like that?"
Wait a second. She was objectifying you. She was objectifying you, actually, when you walked by. So I was like, yeah.
You could have gone to HR.
It works both ways, man.
I'm so sick of these wrestling companies just booking me for my good, you know, for my good physique and like, you know, making me wear these spandex trunks and, you know, show off my body and stuff. Like, you know,
and then when you're not wearing the spandex trunks, you go with the $600 suits. You know,
I want to be appreciated for my wrestling ability and nothing else.
Right.
Because that's what the wrestling business is all about, guys. Just wrestling. Not, it's got nothing to do with entertainment, nothing to do with charisma or talking or look or anything to do with it. It's only about how people are at wrestling holds.
Right.
Are we kind of like, isn't that, remember when the whole objectifying women thing was a thing like a year ago or two and everything, but everybody kind of like smart enough says, okay, all right, enough girls, because like, if that's going to be what you're trying to preach, it's like, you're not practicing that on Instagram.
Let me give you an example.
Go ahead.
Friend of the show, what's the guy that's married to her? Cardona? Chelsea Green. What's that guy? Mark Cardona. Okay. Friend of the show. Okay. She got mad because somebody was saying something about her physique. And then you watch her on Instagram, like, what are you talking about? Is it okay for you to do, but nobody else? They're appreciating your body, bro.
Right.
They're putting you over because you're sexy. You're going to tell me that's not something that happens every day in every man and every woman's head when they're watching something on TV. Wow, that looks like a star. She looks sexy.
Yeah, dude. Well, and, you know, Mickey would be the first one to – the reason I feel comfortable talking about this is because Mickey's, like, one of the boys. Like, she's the first one to say this stuff. She'd be like, this is – I can't tell you how many times she – like, I've talked to her. She'd be like, oh, they wouldn't let me wear this thing on TV because they said it was too revealing. And, like, this is a – you know, like, she's just like, I'm pro, you know, and it's like, I work hard for this. Like, you know, like
– Bro, look at all these girls that are making bank, like, Paige on Twitch because she's wearing a bikini or the she's wearing, and the OnlyFans and all these girls on Twitch playing video games and lingerie. Like, do you think the guys are there just to play games with them?
The last place we need limitations is the wrestling business.
Right.
Plus, too, this is so hypocritical. I was just thinking about this just now. Everybody's all bitching and complaining about how the WWE is like suppressing the third-party content, right? And you're also like, oh, they can't do that. Everything. But then the girls, when they do go out and like try to promote themselves in third party content, they get onto them for doing that.
Right.
So it's like, you know, because like, well, wait a second, bro. It's just people. Here's the thing. It's the we're just basically hostage right now to whatever the fake outrage culture decides they're going to try to strangle you with their mob and stuff and everything, and try to, like, you know, try to beat you down and throw rocks at you and stuff and thing for coming up with a sensible position that probably a lot of people agree with, but they're scared to join you in being in agreeing because they're scared of the mob coming to choke you out.
I use that exact phrase yesterday. Me and Mickey were talking about some of this stuff, and I said it's being held hostage, like, by this vocal group of fans.